Well, you all asked for it, and now I present my discussion video on the ending to Panty and Stocking with Garter Belt and why I thoroughly enjoyed it. And if you did not catch the hint, I'll be going in depth on the ending to Panty and Stocking. And if you have not seen Panty and Stocking with Garter Belt and you don't want the ending ruined for yourself, don't watch this video. It's that obvious. Just go away. But if you don't care what the ending is, or you don't care for spoilers, or you already seen the ending, welcome friends. And before I begin this discussion video, I want to give a quick shout out to Pathagorin743. Happy birthday, my friend. Hopefully it was an awesome one. Sorry that I gave you a shout out in the worst video possible, in a spoiler video. Hopefully you saw Panty and Stocking with Garter Belt, right? And if not, I mean, you can stop watching the video now. But now, let's get into the discussion. So the ending begins right where Panty and Stocking already defeated the mayor of Dotson City, and they're heading back to the church with Garter Belt, Brief, and Chuck. So they all get out of the car and they're heading into the church, and Panty's acting like her normal self. She's like, yo, I'm fucking hungry. What are we eating tonight? And Stocking begs the question, hey, Panty, you know how our angelic shit can, you know, slice up demons and beat ghosts and whatnot, and we don't hurt humans with it? What does it do to angels? And Panty's like, fuck if I know. I mean, you're gonna have to try it. And right when she said that, Stocking stabs Panty in the head, and all of us just went, and then she slices her up, and then we see her, like, crumble into, like, little bitty pieces, and you see the reaction shot of Chuck, Brief, and Garter Belt. They're all like, what the fuck just happened? After Panty gets eviscerated by Stocking's blades, we see Brief react in a Tex Avery manner, like, aah! And Garter Belt's like, that's not part of the plan. And all of a sudden he's like, aah! And explodes, like, oh my god! Which honestly is the funniest moment in this entire scene, because normally when somebody explodes, it's after they get attacked, but he did not get attacked at all, and he just spontaneously explodes. I found that hilarious, especially Chris Sabat's reaction when he explodes. Spot on, that was a perfect delivery. And so right after Garter Belt explodes, we see the mayor of Dotson City just rise up from Brief's junk area, pop up and say, oh my god, she cut her into 666 pieces. That's the most hilarious thing ever. And then we see just Brief just demoralized. He's like, Stocking, why? And Stocking's like, well, I'm sorry, but surprise, I'm a demon. I really would have loved for her to say, surprise, motherfucker. And so the tear-shaped mayor explains to Brief that in order to save his beloved Panty, he's gonna leave him a trail of Panty crumbs leading to this new city called Olton City, where the new keyhole will be, and he has to stick his junk into the keyhole, open up the gates of hell once again, and then he can have his Panty back. And then they go off on their merry way with Stocking in hand, and we see Garter Belt just rebirth himself, and everyone's still shocked, like, what the fuck just happened? Especially the demon sisters, they were shocked too. You see them on the side of the church, and they're like, what? That came out of left. What? And then you got Garter Belt going, go! Follow the Panty Trail! Brief and Chuck, be on your way! And then it ends saying, to be continued in the next season. Now, I totally understand why people would be angry about an ending like this. I mean, they totally did a 180 of a character that we grew to love and understand, Stocking, and turned her into this demonic, terrible person that we didn't like at all. It was such a bait and switch and such a 180 that we were like, why? We love this character, and all of a sudden she's just gonna turn on us like that? And in that, I understand why a lot of people hate the ending, but for me, I thoroughly enjoyed the ending for the main fact that it's such a shocking ending that you never would expect it. This was the first time in a long time that a twist actually surprised me. A lot of people told me, like, oh, you're not gonna like the ending. Oh, the ending's gonna be terrible, and I was like, okay, so do they not get into heaven? Is that why I'm not gonna like the ending? But when I found out that, you know, we find out Stocking is actually a demon, I was thoroughly shocked. I did not see that coming, although I felt like there were subtle hints, and I'll get into that as the video continues. And so let me give you my personal opinions as to why I really enjoyed the ending. First off, it was just a genuine treat and shock. I did not see this coming at all. I love to be surprised like this. I was thoroughly shocked, and I thoroughly enjoyed every moment of the ending. Also, one thing that I grew to understand about Panty and Stocking with Garter Belt, although it's not a deep anime, the whole message of the anime is that things are not what they seem, and they play this prevalently in the series. Like, you see Panty and Stocking, they're supposed angels and they lived in heaven for a while, but if you looked at them in real life, if you never knew they were angels, would you honestly think that they were angels? No! You would think that there's these two slutty bitches who cuss and do a lot of crazy shit and blow stuff up. You would never in your life think that they were angels. And you go to the demon girls. When you look at them, they're sophisticated, they're well kept, they have great grammar. You would think that they're very responsible citizens. You would never think for a second, if not for the Redskin, that they were demons. And that's one thing that's played prevalently in this series, that things are not quite what they seem. And also throughout the entire series, I felt like they were hinting at the fact that there's more to the character of Stalky than there seems to be. I mean, first, she's a goth girl who hides some secrets. Out of the two of them, she is the nicest one. And if you see how they portray the demons, they're very well kept, well mannered, you know, sort of nice. I mean, yes, Stalking does have her moments where she's very foul-mouthed and out of control, bombastic, but normally she's the level-headed one of the group, so you kind of see that play off. And not only that, she fell in love with a ghost. She's the only one that actually saw a ghost as something more, and I think only a demon would see a ghost as something more. Or maybe I'm just looking too much into it, but that's how I felt. There was a secret about the character of Stalking that was not shown until the last episode. And the last reason that I really liked the ending is that it gave us hope for a second season. I mean, just think about it. Wouldn't you like to see Panny and Stalking clash in the second season because of this dispute? I think that would be awesome. And only that, we get maybe more of a development for Brief and Garterbell. Maybe they'll go on the journey to find Panny, and you know, we have this back and forth, him trying to hit on Brief. That'd be funny. I want to see more of that. Though Chuck as a character, not so much. And maybe they might even team up with the Demon Sisters. I mean, that would be really awesome. There are so many promises to this new season when they make it. I mean, it just makes me happy and excited. I mean, wouldn't you be excited to see another season of Panty and Stalking? I mean, though Panty and Stalking would not be in it prevalently because Panty's a bunch of pieces and Stalking's just like sitting there waiting for, you know, them to come. Or maybe we'll find out that she was a double agent and actually played the demon and the angel role. Who knows? There's just so many promises. That's why I'm really excited, and I hope they are gonna make a second season. I heard that a second season is gonna come out this year, and I will be looking forward to that. And that is my reasons as to why I like the ending. And like I mentioned time and time again, this is just my personal thoughts on a subject. You might have a differing opinion, maybe you might outright disagree with me, or maybe you might have a new perspective on things, be like, you know what, he brings up some valid points, maybe I was a bit too harsh on the ending. And I would like to know, do you guys agree with my points? Has your opinion and perspective changed about the ending now that I explained a little more about how I felt? Or is your opinion still the same and you still outright hate it? So comment below and let me know. That's what this discussion video is all about. Until then, hit that subscribe button. If you're new to my channel, welcome to the Black Critic Guy. More videos to come, I promise you. Like this video if you really enjoyed it. And I'm Tony Watley II from the Black Critic Guy. Till then, peace, YouTube.